Hey guys, how's it going? All right, tonight I'm having a chicken and tomato sandwich. I'm hungry, but at the same time I'm not wanting to eat. I'm almost tempted to just have a tomato sandwich. So maybe I should have, I don't know. Before I do anything, I have got to get some chocolate milk. Dying of thirst here. House is hot. I'm dying of thirst. Yeah. Oh, that's good. All right. Let's tackle this big boy. Some sourdough bread, a little bit of mayonnaise on there. I don't know if I can eat. I'm definitely probably not gonna be able to eat all of this. I don't know why I chose to eat such a big sandwich. I'm not gonna be able to eat all of this. It's good though. So how are you guys doing? Good, I hope. Oh, yeah. I want a little bit of salt and vinegar crackers also. Not much. So I'm not going to be able to eat all that. Probably should have cut the patty in half even. I cut the bread in half. There's no way I could eat a huge long sandwich like that. A little salt and vinegar chips once in a while. I forgot to show you guys. Went to the Amish store the other day when we went over to get our chickies, our new chickies. I got some roasted no salt soy nuts. I love soy nuts. I can't find them at our local Walmart. I used to be able to find them all the time where we used to live, but they were salted and oftentimes they had a little too much salt on them. I think I prefer them with no salt, more natural. It was a bigger bag. I've already ate part of it. Should I spill this? I got some large pearl tapioca. I can figure out how to do it. I've never done it. If I can figure out how to do it, I'm wanting to make some bubble tea, something like that. Okay. So, yay! And I got some chia seed. Is that how you say it? Some chia seed over there. It was like 1 pound and 4 ounces for $4.30. I don't remember what it was at Walmart, but I think it was less and cost more. So, I'll figure out how to do that too, because I've never made anything with chia seed. So I've been wanting to. I've seen all these little chia seed parfaits and all this kind of stuff, and they look so yummy. So I'm gonna try it. I see. So our chickies are doing good, our new ones and our old ones. Older. So they're all getting along. Well, the older ones are picking on the little ones just a little bit, but not bad at all. I actually sat out there for about an hour and a half, 2 hours tonight, watching them and seeing how they interact. And the older ones kind of scold the little ones occasionally. Particularly Lucy, when they get too close to her scraps of food, because she wants all the goodies to herself. She's a little pig. But overall, they're doing good. I sat out there and picked up and held both Lucy at different times, held both Lucy and Buffy on my lap, give them some attention. Lucy is doing really good. She's finally healed up and got getting better. Messy, messy. You know I'm getting messy if I gotta get the towel. I'm so tired today. I gotta go to the doctor's office today. Both hubby and I had doctor's appointments. They gave him a different prescription for his chest pain, which is caused from the GERD. He's been having such tremendous chest pain that there's been times I almost thought he was having a heart attack because it was that bad. So I got him into the doctor's office and combined it's just from the GERD, and so they put him on a different medication. Hopefully that helps and quick, because it was treating that and his back pain or kidney pain, whatever it is, being in extreme pain from that also. I don't know if it's kidney stones or I have no idea. They're going to do an ultrasound here. They're going to call in a couple days and confirm a date for ultrasound, but him being so much pain between those two things is making me worry and stress and everything, and then I can't sleep. I have sleep issues as it is. So hopefully we got a couple things, how do you say it, fixed on him, or at least in the process of getting fixed. Inquired about my extreme fatigue issue. You know, always being tired, and I can't do daily squat because always being so tired. And my sleep issues and all that kind of stuff. Waking up startled and everything. Supposedly, let me get a bite. I thought it was going to be like, you know, my issues from what's it called? Fibromyalgia, or what you call it, or Lyme's disease, or any number of things. My mind was racing of what it could be. Come find out. It's depression. From massive long-term amounts of stress, anxiety, and depression. Sad. So, I guess that's what it boils down to, is sad.
stress, anxiety, and depression. Like, okay. So, I guess I at least officially know what my issue is now. So, which, I didn't want to believe it at first, but the more I've been thinking about it throughout the day, it kind of makes sense because even before we moved in with my mom and daddy a year ago, where we lived at our old place, I was extremely, extremely stressed. I had massive anxiety and depression because trying to take care of everything myself on a low-income paying job, worrying about hubby because, you know, he has all his health issues and him being disabled and everything. And that was my income was our only income. Trying to keep up with all the bills, medications. He was paying like out of pocket like $250 to $300 in cash on medications alone. So it's hard to keep up with and try to keep up with the bills too. So, I'd be crying in the back of the kitchen at work when nobody was around. I didn't mean to, it would just happen. I'd be screaming at the top of my lungs and bawling half of the ways home out of stress and frustration and everything. Worry. Didn't have anybody close by that could help me with things, and the ones that could oftentimes would back out of help me after they'd say they'd help me. Things like that. I didn't have anybody. My lawnmower broke down at one point, and I didn't have anybody to mow my yard. I had a tiny yard. It was only like, from the sides of the trailer, it was probably only maybe 5 feet out away from the trailer is our property line on both sides. 5 feet on both sides of the trailer. Tiny yard. But my lawnmower died, and I couldn't get anybody to help me mow it. So I had to go out there and pull grass by hand, trying to go around all the yard to try to pull grass, just to keep the grass from being too tall and the city being on my butt. Tiny yard or not, when you're trying to get out there in the summer heat and pull all that by hand, it's impossible. So, you know, all that kind of stuff. And then, I was actually literally on the verge of a mental breakdown a couple times. I scared a couple of my coworkers, I think, at work, because when I was chopping green peppers, I was stabbing, freaking my coworkers out. But yeah, so I guess I can see where depression would actually kind of eventually wear on my body and make it where I can't do dilly squat. I was thinking it was something else, something more than just depression, which actually I shouldn't chalk it up to just depression, because mental disorders are serious. This, you know, depression and mental disorders. So, I just never realized that it had this much of a toll on my body. So, and I never, I was purposely trying to stress over things and everything. Just, you know, when you care about somebody, you know, get all weepy. But anyway, so, no. Hopefully I'm not getting too cringy. I apologize if I am. I'm not trying to. But, so yeah, I guess that's officially my problem. So, the doctor is up to my anxiety / depression medication, so hopefully that will help. And he said that that's part of my sleep issue too, the waking up startled and everything, and the nightmares, nightmares is because of the stress and worry and everything. Stress, worry, depression. So hopefully the medication will help with that also. We shall see. In the meantime, chocolate milk helps. Mine is crumbs. And chickies. And kitties. Might have to get some more. So anywho, I guess that's what boils down to is depression. If I had known that, there's nothing I could do. You can't always control your emotions. Maybe you can to a degree, but when you're in a stressful situation because you worry about somebody, and the doctors, in previous times I went to the doctors, like, tell me not to worry about things. Those things are said and done. I can't just turn off my emotions. I'm not a robot. So, I'm trying to do better, at least, telling things. I'm rambling a little bit tonight. Sorry. So, and I guess that could be part of why I've gotten where, different times, actually. I don't eat very much, other than when I'm on video. If it wasn't for doing videos, I probably wouldn't hardly eat at all. So, I probably am going to have to go back to putting the calorie counting app on my phone again, so I can get back to, like I had to a couple months ago, thanks to Tyler Amy telling me about the app, counting my calories and see where I'm at, because I got water there for a while. I was barely eating at all. So I had to get in the habit of logging my food into the app, counting my calories, just to make sure I ate enough. Because I was only eating, for a while, I was only eating like 200-300 calories a day, I think. So, need to eat a little bit more than that. I will admit that since we have moved in with my mom and daddy almost a year ago, I am less stressed. Much, much less stressed. But, like I said, everything has taken a toll on my body over the time from before we moved in. So, no way I'm going to be able to finish this. Way too much. Even without the eating issues, I still couldn't eat all this. Technically, because I'm not one to eat. I was actually done when I got like five bites in. That's how little I've been wanting to eat lately. I could just sit and drink, actually the last couple of nights I have, just sit and drink chocolate milk and then go to bed and call it good. Not eat anything, just drink chocolate milk. And I know that's not healthy. I need to keep my strength up so I can take care of my hubby and my parents, my elderly parents. I will say elderly grandparents, like, wait a minute, they're not my grandparents. Sometimes I know it sounds stupid, but sometimes I mentally think of myself as being younger than I am. But my body reminds me that I'm not. I'm done with that. I can't eat any more of that. It's too much. Too much meat. I think if I just... Maybe I take the... This way. Anywho, what about you guys? Have you ever had such tremendous stress that is affecting your body in any sort of way? Let me know your experiences. And have you been able to fix things where you get back to feeling normal? I have no idea even how to get back where I can have more energy like I used to. I used to work at a full-time job, and I can't even hardly do a small load of dishes now without being wore out. It's extremely frustrating. I want to work. So if any of you guys have tips or suggestions or anything about how I can get to mentally and physically feeling better and have more energy, let me know. Like any supplements or something that I could take for energy. I was going to say something, I totally forgot what I was going to say because I seen that little dot that's on my phone. Pops up on my phone still. I don't know what that thing is. It's kind of creeping me out. But, I'm full. But, so yeah, if you have any suggestions of, like, natural remedies or anything like that, let me know. Because if I could just get where I feel better, where I can even just get a part-time job, I'd be happy. What I would love to do. I would actually love to do, so I don't think I can here because we live in too small of a town, is do one of those dog walking jobs. I love animals. I would be in heaven if I did that. I loved being at the Amish farm the other day. I was like, oh. It so reminded me of my grandma's farm. I used to love going to my grandma's farm all the time, even with a stinky poo. I just had to watch my step. You don't fall in it. But, all the animals around and everything, it's like, ugh. So remind me of grandma's. Oh, excuse me. That sourdough reminds me of grandma's also. She used to make homemade bread, and she'd be pulling it out of the oven just as we got to her house. She lived like 3 hours away. So, when we got to her house, she'd oftentimes be just pulling out a fresh loaf out of the oven, and that aroma filling the house. Oh, so amazing. I love grandma's house. I wish I could go back in time and relive some things. So I'll re-experience them. Anywho, I better get ready to go. This is getting kind of long, sorry. Welcome to everybody that's new. And hello to everybody in general. If you've not subscribed and you want to, hit that subscribe button. I probably don't have a cheeky video tonight, but I'll be getting some tomorrow, hopefully. Hopefully. Depending on how I feel. It's just like a one day at a time sort of thing of how I feel. It is seriously frustrating not have any energy. It's like debilitating, really. Which I seriously thought it was, I wouldn't say something more serious, but it really, in all actuality, depression and anxiety and all that kind of stuff is very serious. So I think that's what it was as a society, how we chalk things up. You know, depression is, well, some people, I should say, not everybody, but depression's not as a big deal as other illnesses, but in actuality,
It is. I would never have thought that I'm not able to work because of depression, but yep. Well, hopefully I can change that though, because one day at a time and try to make some positive goals for myself. So, and with you guys' inspiring and sweet comments and prayers, that will help also. So, I thank you guys for all the prayers you've said for Lucy and everything. So, anywho, I'd better scoot. Don't forget to, did I say it yet already? I don't remember. I don't think so. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys again soon. Have a good one. Bye-bye.
Where'd the bug go? I thought she was going to jump on the curtain for a second there. She's watching it.